Hey, what's up, guys? Listen, you and I need to have a heart-to-heart talk. And now this time it's going to be about low back pain and two particular movements that we want to compare and contrast because unbeknowingly, they're very similar, but yet at the same time, they get contrasting responses, okay? And those two movements are going to be the deadlift and the row. And those are very polarizing because we have, at one time, we have a love-hate relationship with the row. Oh, I love the row, or I hate it just because it taxes our lungs. But then at the same time, we say deadlift, and everybody's just like, whoa, wait a second, my back's gonna blow up. So what I wanna do is I just wanna compare and contrast these two styles and actually bring it all together so that you can realize actually how close and similar these really are. The similarity between the row erg and deadlift are that their start positions are exactly the same, and that most fundamental movement is the hip hinge. If you look at it, the start position of the row is actually a much deeper start position than that of the deadlift, but the main principles apply, which are a straight back, hands and arms that just pass the front of the knee, and shins as we drive through the middle of our feet to extend. Aside from the difference in the amount of resistance that we are moving, the only differences between the row and deadlift are that the hips will straighten out fully at the top of the deadlift and that the arms bend at the top of the row. So I hope that dispels your myths and concerns surrounding the legend of the deadlift. And so the next time you get after it, let's just think of that in terms of maintaining good shapes and relationships of pelvis and spine. And you're going to crush it when you get after it. See you next time.